welcome. You're watching Don Bosco Media Network. This is Monali Sarambai, bringing you the Salesian news across the globe. On Saturday, September 10th, Salesians from 13 different countries belonging to the Inter-America and America South Cone regions demonstrated that Salesian devotion to Our Lady transcends all borders. The provincial delegates for formation and social communication, in fact, took a break from the work of their joint meeting to visit the National Shrine of Our Lady of Aparecida. For many of these Salesians, it was their first trip to Brazil. Father Carlos Castillo, delegate for formation of the Mexico province, was impressed by the size and care of the Aparecida Shrine. This is a place I wanted to get to know, also because of the importance of the document of the 5th Conference of the Latin American Bishops Council, which was pronounced here. And the manifestations of the devotion of these peoples, the affection of the people, the atmosphere of fraternity, peace and serenity experienced here are very significant, he said. The path of energy efficiency on the campus of the Salesian Pontifical University, UPS, continues. Started in November 2021 in collaboration with Global Power Service, the company contracted to execute the project, UPS has recently obtained the ISO 5001 certification, which attests to the efficiency of the energy management systems put in place by UPS. The entire academic community, staff, students, faculty and residents are involved in an active way in this journey and to ever more attentive care of the common house. A renewed vision of the relationship between man and nature, which is not only about reducing plastic or using renewable resources, but also about food waste, climate change and sustainable mobility. At a time of great drought and extraordinary natural phenomena, the Salesian University courageously renews its commitment to protecting the planet, as Pope Francis also reminded us recently, aiming to increasingly improve the daily actions of all members of the educational community to promote a new ecological culture. Coordinated by Father Ricardo Carlos, Provincial Superior of the St. Alfonso's Maria de Liguori, province of Brazil Campo Grande, and Sister Terenzinha Ambroisim, Superior of the Daughters of Mary Help of Christians of the Mother Mazzarello province, a meeting of missionaries active in work with indigenous people was held from September 1st to 3rd. It was attended by religious active in the houses of Seventina São Marcos Mururi and Sango Douro, along with some missionaries from the Indigenous Missionary Council, CIMI. The meeting's objective was to update the missionary directory, which is part of the history of the missionary province of Mato Grosso. The document was drafted as it was felt to be a necessity by missionaries working with the native Bororo and Zavante peoples. The missionaries, in the persons of Father Rudolf Lukenbein, Father Gonzalo Ochao, Sister Ada Gamburato and many other Salesians, enlightened by the Second Vatican Council and the Special General Chapter of 1973, guided the development of all the work so that this document could be drafted, a work that continued until 1975 and was finally approved in 1976 under the name of Directory, explained Father Alderson de Oliveira, Provincial Delegate for Missions. At an event marking Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, 75 years of India's independence, a Literacy Day, Church Art Kolkata honoured 3 Salesians for outstanding contributions to society along with several other eminent citizens at Indian Council for Cultural Relations Kolkata in Satyajit Ray Auditorium on September 8, 2022. The Salesian achievers honoured were Bishop George Pali Parambil of the My Diocese of Eastern Arunachal, Father Skaria Nedumantahil of Don Bosco Human Resource Center, West Minapur, and Father C.M. Paul, Director of Radio Salesian Darjeeling. On September 7th, in the city of Montevideo, where the interprovincial novitiate has been held for 3 years, the provincials of Argentina, Uruguay, Paraguay, and Chile met to accompany this formative experience. The curatorium was chaired by Father Gabriel Romero, counselor for the America Southern Cone region. The process of personal accompaniment of each of the novices, the formation proposal and the pastoral activities they carry out on weekends with the students of El Paiva in the interior of the country were appreciated. The novices from these 4 countries are having a good experience of internationality and interculturation, typical of the Salesian formation proposal. So viewers, that is all we have for you today. Until we meet again, thank you for watching.